Hey guys, so I mentioned making this video a couple of videos back and a lot of you said that you would love to see it. So here it is. What is in my day-to-day makeup bag? Now I'm aware I talk about makeup a lot on this channel, but I'm also aware that a lot of the time I'm talking about monthly favorites, I'm talking about new releases, and it doesn't always translate to actually what I'm using at the moment. Obviously, part of my job is trying out new products and kind of reviewing new products, so I do always usually have something new on my face in terms of like things that I'm trying out day to day. But if I'm ever getting ready in 5 minutes to run out the door, or if I'm traveling, I tend to take my kind of day to day makeup bag with me, and this is what it looks like. A lot of you guys will probably be quite surprised about how small it is. In terms of, I have a lot of products in my dressing table and kind of in my collection, but in terms of if I go somewhere for the weekend or even for a week away, I'll take a makeup bag this size, because I tend to use things that are a lot of things that are multi-use, but also things that I know that I love and like old staples. So this is my current, so like kind of like a current favorites, but also like what's in my makeup bag at the moment, because a lot of it is things that have been there for ages, including tools as well. So why don't we talk about brushes and tools first? So on a day-to-day basis, I tend to have just four brushes, a spoolie and a makeup sponge in my bag. So starting off with the beauty blender. I have used a beauty blender for my foundation for a really long time now. I feel like it's one of those things that every time I use a brush now, I'm a bit like, it's just not as good as a beauty blender. I obviously normally use it damp. Using a dry beauty blender is horrendous. I wouldn't recommend it. This one is dirty because I used it yesterday. I would say today, but definitely I use a different one today because it's not like big from being wet. So this is just dingling around in my makeup bag. I usually try and wash them. I actually have quite a lot of them, so I rotate them all until I need to wash all of them, because I hate washing beauty blenders. It's horrendous. It just takes ages, and the microwave trick just doesn't work as well. Am I doing something wrong? I don't know. Anyway, so I tend to get like a week's worth of use out of a beauty blender. Is that too much? Mm. I have a spoolie for doing my eyebrows. This one is the Tweezerman and Huda Beauty collaboration that came out. It's probably about 2 years old now, but it's really good. It's just a tiny little travel one and it's good. And then I have a selection of brushes. A lot of the brushes that I go back to are actually my Hakuhodo brushes, which I've had for years. They are so good. This one, all of the labeling has come off and I don't even know what it is, but this is the one that I use as a bronzer. So I have a bronzer brush, I have a blush brush, which I also use for highlight as well. And then I have a blending brush. Sometimes I'll have like a lid color brush, but a lot of the time with my eyeshadow, I'll put on a base color with this brush, and then I will also get a blending, like a contoury, like outer corner kind of color, and I'll blend it with this brush as well, and then I'll clean the brush so I don't have another brush with me. If I'm going somewhere super swanky, I'll take like maybe two or three of these, and just like if I'm doing something a bit more major with my eyes, but day to day. And then I have a pencil brush, which I use to smudge my eyeliner slash eyeshadow, depending on what I'm using. I'll smudge it like under my eyes and then also like on the outer corner, and just I find pencil brushes super useful and I use them every single day. So they are like my daily tools. In terms of where the other brushes are from, I have kind of a lot of different brushes and I tend to rotate them, but these are some of my favorites. The bronzer one is Hakuhodo. The blush one is from Smith, which is really good, but I also have a very similar Hakuhodo one as well, which is just doing the rounds. It's probably dirty at the moment, so I tend to do that with all my brushes. I use them all until they're dirty. And then this one is from NARS, which is really good. I've had this for ages. And then this is from Zoeva. But I also, again, have a really good, actually both of these, I have really good Hakuhodo ones that replace those as well. And they are my favorite. Like if you're gonna invest in brushes, 100% Hakuhodo, like they're just, I've had them for, I think some of them I probably had for like 8 years and they're brilliant. Then when it comes to makeup, so first of all, talking about base, at the moment my kind of go-to, and it has been for probably over 6 months, is the Chanel CC cream. This is the Complete Correction with SPF 50. I like this for a couple of different reasons. Firstly, because it has SPF 50 in the actual base itself. I also do use a SPF 50 moisturizer too, but I feel like there are very few face makeups that have SPF 50 and it's really good. It's still really light. It's a really moisturizing texture, but it has decent coverage. It's not like full coverage, but it has decent like everyday coverage. This, I think this shade is 30, which is beige, and I probably do need 20 because this is kind of my summer color, but this tends to be something that I go for every day because it's easy to apply. Also, it applies beautifully with your fingers if you're in a mega hurry and you just want to like dot a little bit on and kind of just give yourself a little bit of something, a little bit of coverage. I really like this, and it's something that's, I think it came out, it's a part of the spring collection last year, and I've had it as part of my kind of general rotation since then. Then in terms of powder, I feel like a broken record with this one, but this is the Hourglass Unlocked palette. This is so good if you are considering buying an Hourglass palette or even just a single powder, because the palettes are a lot more value for money. This is the best one. It's so good. I've used it so much. It still looks like I've barely used it. Actually, the bronzer is kind of starting to get a bit of a dent in it now, but I use this pretty much every day. I use it on my face and I use it on my eyes. So today, the only eyeshadow that I'm wearing is actually this. I use the powder as a face powder to set my makeup. I then use these ones like as a kind of like nice warm bronze. I then use these as a blush, and then there's a highlighter in there as well. And then for my eyes, I love using the highlighter on my eyes, and then I use the bronzer color as well as a contour. It's kind of a warm contour, but I really like it. And then I also sometimes use the blush colors on my eyes as well. This palette is just, I honestly reach for it more than anything else in my whole makeup setup. It's so good. And I have got a few others of these that I don't ever reach for. So like the unlocked one is where it's at, in my opinion. Just my opinion. This is all just my opinion. Love it. Another Hourglass product that's in my makeup bag and has been since probably October is the oil. I have to say, I love this, but it is super expensive and I was given it. So I feel like I would repurchase this. I was given this one as well. I've probably given all of these products, guys. FYI, disclaimer. I get given a lot of products. I feel like a broken record saying that in every single video now, but if you've missed, or if you're not from the UK and you've missed all of this disclaimer stuff that's been going on, it's kind of changed things, but I'm hoping that you guys don't mind me waffling on about it every now and again. Anyway, I would repurchase this in a flash, and these are £69. Like if I broke it, I would go and get it again instantly because I use it so much and I love it. The oil, I love it and I use it, but I'm like, hey, that's kind of expensive for an oil. But I do like it, and it's in my makeup bag, and this is just a legit video of what is in my makeup bag and what I use. I actually also have another Hourglass product, which is the Scattered Light eyeshadow, and this is the only, actually, I have one other individual eyeshadow. This is if I want to jazz up the look a bit. So this is like super spangly, like rose gold glittery eyeshadow. It's gorgeous. And then the other individual one I have is more of a recent discovery, actually, in the last 2 months. This is really messy and disgusting. This is a NARS individual, and it's called Cabo San Lucas. It is such a gorgeous mauvey, nudey, I would say it's matte, but it's definitely got like a satiny sheen to it. It's so pretty, and you can wear this just on its own so easy, like wham bam done, eyeshadow over. I also really like the tiny little NARS compacts. Like a lot of the time I would just use this on my eyes and it's not gonna take up a lot of space, kind of thing. So love that. And then other stuff that I use on my eyes, I always have a black eyeliner. I like to use it for smudgy. Sometimes I will use, if I've got like an eyeshadow palette and I'm using that, sometimes I will use the dark color under my eyes and then on my lash line as well. But at the moment I've been using my MAC Feline. This is a classic, an oldie but a goodie. I really, really love this, so good. And that is that kind of always in my makeup bag, or like being replaced by something similar. I like the Trish McAvoy ones as well. And then the other thing that is in my makeup bag, fairly new addition that I've spoken about recently, is the new Benefit Roller Liner Eyeliner. Again, I always have a liquid eyeliner. I don't wear one every single day, but I go through phases with them, so I kind of always have one in my makeup bag, whether or not it's this or the YSL one, or the Tarte one is also really good. We usually have one, and this is my kind of current one. And then other eye stuff, mascara. Again, I change my mascara all the time, but as you guys know, if you've watched this or my January favorites video, my Lancôme Hypnose is like my current choice of mascara. Really love this one. But other good ones include the YSL one. I love the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes and Lights Camera Flashes. I change my mascara that I'm using a lot, so that's always something that's kind of transient, as well as like more fuller coverage foundations. I don't have one in my makeup bag right now, but I have loads of them on the go, and occasionally one of them will make it into like my day-to-day one, but at the moment they all tend to be really high coverage. So I've been testing out the new Hourglass one, which is super high coverage, the Dual one, which is actually not that high coverage, but it's just on my dressing table instead of my makeup bag, and also the new Tarte Shape Tape. Is it called the Shape? It's basically the Shape Tape foundation. Anyway, that's also really good, but super high coverage. Like, I wouldn't wear it day-to-day, just around the house kind of thing. So yeah, I'm waffling on. Okay, moving on. Oh, I forgot my concealer. This is a freaking amazing concealer as well. The Tarte Creaseless Concealer, so good. I love a lot of Tarte products, but this is amazing. I've got 20N light, so neutral light color. I use this under my eyes and on any spots, and it's freaking amazing. So good, so good. And it doesn't crease like it says, like the name would suggest. And then lastly for my brows, I have my own brow range with Ilo. If you guys didn't know, it's pretty exciting. It's been out for, I think it's been out for like, is it 2 years now? Oh my God, ages, at least a year. Yeah, I didn't have a baby, so it's at least a year. I think it's 2 years. So I use every single day, I use this, which is the Brow Define double-ended super fine pencil. And then when I'm feeling like I want a bit of extra, I use this, which is the double-ended gel. So in this you get a clear gel and then a tinted gel, and I use this on days where I need my makeup to last a really long time. So if I'm out and about meetings or whatever all day, or if I've got a shoot, or if I'm filming, I will use this. If I'm kind of just out and about running errands or at home, I'll just use a pencil. And I love this pencil. I love dual use products and double ended things, because I think they allow you to kind of customize what you're doing so much more than if you just have like an individual, just a plain brow pencil. So this has a lighter and a darker shade, and I tend to use the darker shade to fill in any holes in the actual body of my brow, and then do the tail, and then I use the lighter shade to do the hair, like hair strokes at the front, and then also to sharpen up the line underneath. And then obviously with this, I use the clear if I don't want any like serious browage. And then I use the tinted one if I need a bit of help. At the moment, I had my brows colored last week, like I tint them and they did them too dark, and I have serious eyebrows. So if in the last couple of videos you've noticed my eyebrows looking a bit funky, it's because they dyed them with the light. I think they used the dark brown instead of the medium brown, and they were really intense for a week or so. So yes, they are my brow products from Ilo. You can get them in Boots if you haven't seen already. I would recommend. And then last but not least, lip product. I change up my lip products loads, as you guys would expect, and as I'm sure you guys probably do, but my most recent like reach for all the time, always have in my makeup bag, is this one, which is NARS Velvet Lip Glide in Roseland. This is what I'm wearing at the moment. It's the most perfect rosy nude. It's so gorgeous. And what I really like about this is it's not quite matte, but it's not a gloss. It feels really comfortable to wear. It's like, as the name would suggest, it's a lip glide. Like, it's very smooth, it's comfy, it's pretty looking. It's not super, super matte, but I don't like that look anyway, and I find it so uncomfortable. Like, I can't wear those matte lipsticks because they drive me nuts. It's almost like, you know, nails down a blackboard, or like polystyrene or cotton wool or things that some people can't stand. For me, that's that matte lip. I'm like, ah, get it off me. So yes. The NARS one is really good, but also I tend to go back to like my classic MAC lipstick shades, whatever is kind of off the moment, but this is kind of sticking. Like, I've been using this every single day for a couple of weeks. So that is what's in my makeup bag. And if you're wondering about my makeup bag itself, I don't actually know where this is from. It just says Lua in the label. This was a Christmas present from my friend Jess, and I really like it a lot. It's like maroon velvet with a glittery rose gold star. Love it. That is it for this video. I hope you have all enjoyed it. And I will see you again very soon. Bye. That was a really enthusiastic way of like, bye, bye.